Hey, what's going on? I'm James from Party Time Brewing. Today we are going to try brewing a bag. It's the first time I've ever done it. I got a 20-gallon pot and a Hellfire burner. Let's see how she goes.
Party time, party time, party time brews. Brew in a bag isn't that hard to use. Party time, party time, party time brews. Harry and the Hendersons made a hop for me to choose.
So what we're doing today is trying out the new kettle I got. It's a first generation Blickman with probably a first generation Hellfire. I don't know if there was different generations, but it's a bunch of used gear, 20 gallons. So I'm gonna be trying to do a 3-keg batch. What's that? 15 gallons, math. Yeah, okay, so I'm gonna fire it up. Go get a lighter.
Quick note to self, when you're using 140,000 BTU burner, you don't need to turn it up too much. These gauges are kind of nice. They show you the different ranges of the things you're going to be doing in the pot. Nice and visual. Now back to brewing. Here's my water profile. I'm doing a lager, so we're basically just using RO water with a very small amount of chemicals. Or additions. Additions sounds better. So let's talk grains. 14 kilograms of Pilsner, also known as 100% Pilsner. This is a 60 liter batch if I didn't mention it already. And I'm throwing it through the grain mill a second time for the double crush. This is one of the first batches that I needed to do multiple runs of the grinder. Proudest moment ever. Now it's time to play around with the brew bag. This is the first time I set it up, had some clips in the kitchen, and it seemed to go in there nice. Used a spoon to widen it out. Dump in the grain. Stir it up. It's really not that hard. Stir it again. Make sure there's no dough balls. Keep stirring it. Dump in some more. Stir some more. No dough balls. Looking good. One last little slam and we are just about good. Everything's ready to cover and go. Unless I decide I didn't put enough grain in. I believe I put 14 overall, but before I put the 14 overall, I had thought that 12 or so would be good. I was being cheap. So I did a couple more kilograms and started in, put the top on, covered it up with a sleeping bag, tied a rope around it, and waited. So now we're going to take a look at the setup for getting the grain bag out of this 15-ish gallon batch. The folding ladder is a great way to go since it doesn't have the crossbars in the middle. The top rungs are a good place to tie a line on, or you can just attach directly to one of the rungs. If I get some motivation, I'm going to notch out some 2x4s and screw in a screw eye or eyelet or screw thing with circle at end. Not quite sure the terminology on it, but you might get the idea. Here's a picture.
For my pulley system, I opted to go for the block and tackle method. This particular one was about 30 bucks. It says it's good for 4,000 pounds, but I might trust it with 1 or 200 pounds. Definitely not lifting cars and whatnot. But it's perfect for the bigger brew bag. And it has a 4-to-1 ratio, so for every 40 pounds you're lifting, it's only about 10 pounds effort. Nice and easy. Off with the sleeping bag. Let's check how the temperature did. Not too shabby, still at 145. If I stirred it, it probably would have shown a bit higher. Setting it up, just need to hook all the corners to see how this block and tackle works out. Pretty damn easy and can just wrap it around the ladder and it holds pretty well. The only thing with this block and tackle is that it barely pulls the bag high enough. I'll eventually set up an extension for the ladder so it works a bit better. But the 8-foot ladder works pretty good for this case.
And we are looking at right around 1051 as our pre-boil gravity. So she's gonna be a little spicier than I thought. Probably might be sitting more around the 5.5, maybe even 6% after the boil. Well, maybe not 6, but at least 5.5 or somewhere around there. Okay, so she's down to a trickle. Might as well get the grain bag out of there. Just gonna put it into a bucket. Once the water's out of it, it seems quite easy to manage. It's probably only maybe 40 pounds of grain there. It's not too bad. So let's just see how this works.
With the pulley hooked up, it was really easy to manage that bag and just get it into a bucket so I could empty it later. I like it.
For this batch, I used 45 grams of Sasquatch Hops, which is about 1/2 ounce for each 5-gallon batch. Sasquatch Hops were created by Hops Connect. Here's a little logo since it looks kind of rad. As Canada's first proprietary hop, the feedback panel stated a strong cream, caramel, whatever that is, orange, dark berries, and hay flavors.
And it's boiling time to throw in them hops for the 60 minutes. Now that it's done boiling, let's chill it down with our wort chiller. This is the first time I used an immersion chiller, and it seemed to work pretty good.
So here's how I transfer to the spike fermenter. I like to put a strainer on one of the 1.5-inch tri-clamp openings in order to minimize the hot matter in the fermenter. I'm pretty sure it doesn't matter, but it makes me feel better. Here's what's left from the boil. I kind of messed up and didn't really put any pickup piece inside of the pot, so I ended up sending a bunch of trub into the fermenter because I didn't want to waste 6 or 8 liters at the bottom of the pot. And here goes the yeast. I used some S-189 German Lager Yeast for this bad boy, and about 60 grams. And here's the part where we shake it a bit for a hint of oxygenation. I don't shake it too hard with the spike fermenter because I kind of hate the three-leg system and its ability to tip. I will probably cause some massive damage to it someday when I tip it over. This was one of the first batches that I used gelatin in, so I emptied out the tube and then dumped some gelatin. On the dump valve, I have a 1.5-inch reducer, so it takes a bit of finessing in order to get the tube out. In the future, I'll probably pick up a 1-inch reducer to go that way, even though it will probably waste a bit more and not have as much control. And here's what you want to see, me screwing up. I tried to attach the tap and it leaked, just like it had in the past, and I did nothing about it. So I found an O-ring and it worked as good as new. Always have O-rings handy to save the day. And since I always miss it in the tasting, I ended up topping up the fermenter a little bit, so I ended up with an original gravity of 1.05, final gravity 1.008 for 5.5%.
Okay, so this is the Sasquatch Lager, my first brew-in-a-bag run, and let's see how she pours. Way too much pressure. Took a bit of Pilsner glass, but that should be all right. We'll just see how she works out. My attempt at gelatin fining didn't seem to work that great in this. As you can see, she's pretty hazy. Could have to be due to the fact that this thing leaked out pretty much all over the floor. I had a party the other day and people left the taps open, so half of this keg disappeared. And as well, I just noticed the O-ring sucked, as you saw, and half of it's gone. So I have a glass or two right from the bottom, and that's right from where all the good stuff is. Let's give this a taste, see how she goes. But first, I guess you gotta take a whiff. Has a nice malty character, I guess. Nothing too crazy on the hops, nothing. Well, we're gonna go with no hops, and by no hops, I mean, lately I've only been smelling the citrusy or the stone fruity ones, so haven't tried too many recently with not much hop aroma on it, so give this a shot. Well, that was just a sip of foam, so that doesn't really tell me much. Yeah, it's very malty. I can't even really describe what the Sasquatch flavor is. I'll have to post something maybe right here, and you can see what it's supposed to bring through. Don't know if that's it. Maybe I'll try again. Who knows? The flavor, maybe I'll pick it up on this one. If only I could describe the flavor I'm getting, but I don't. I can't. It's not bad. So it's better to use the Sasquatch hops to brew the beer than to throw them out, but I'm gonna go, I have to go again, because again, I need a professional to help me learn how to taste. Someday I'll be able to tell you how this tastes better. But today, we're just gonna say it's not bad, it's not great. I think I'm gonna start moving back towards the kind of more standard hops, like the Cascade or something like that. This one just doesn't give quite the taste that I'm loving. I'll post, like I said, I posted a little picture there of what the taste is supposed to be like, and yeah, you're just gonna have to keep watching more videos. Maybe I'll use Sasquatch sometime again, but for now, it's an indescribable to a non-beer tasting type person. I'm gonna have to figure out how to taste beer, because this is, well, it's good beer. It just kind of sucks. I can't describe it.
And from the voice of Future James, after looking at the characteristics of this hop, the dominant flavor you were tasting was hay, kind of plain. Hopefully in future iterations of this hop, it will move more towards the orange or dark fruit taste.
Beer. Yeah, it's a good lager. I just can't describe it. Let's see if the next pour maybe is a little better. That's way too much pressure. Just want to see if it's any cleaner. That still just at least has that chill haze. A few pounds too much pressure in there, but yeah, that's what she looks like. That's what I'm gonna go with. And if for some reason you're still watching, it means you need to subscribe, maybe like the video, or dislike. I'm starting to get dislikes, so feel free to dislike this video, especially if you were expecting a very good review of the beer and I came up short. Thank you. Later.